Not since Crocodile Dundee has an Australian film sat on the top of the nation's box office for this long. Lion, the story of a young Indian boy, Saroo, who was lost on a train, is eventually adopted out to Australia, gets a new mum, played by Nicole Kidman, until he grows up and uses Google Maps to find his way back home. The film has swept the world by storm. It's been nominated for a Best Picture Oscar, but it all starts with this man. This is the real Saroo Brierley, and this is the real woman who adopted him, Susan. And this is what really happened.
So firstly, thanks so much for talking to us. I really appreciate your time.
Thanks for having us. Yeah.
Thank you.
What is the absolute earliest memory that you have?
The earliest memory would have been at the age of three. And it's just, you know, flashes up in my memory sometimes. I remember this, I'm in this house and it's sort of darkish and a milkman always used to come in the evening.
How did you manage to hold on to those memories? Were you retelling yourself parts of the story to remember as you were growing up?
It's mostly visuals, because my visuals were heightened right from birth. You know, you're living off your wits, and when you sort of live off your wits, you've got to, you know, think spontaneously on the spot and go. If emotions came in, then I think, you know, that's sort of the end of you. The psychological scarring from being on the train and then coming to Calcutta and going through the hardship, then going to sleep as well at night and just reliving what had happened to those times in India as a child. It just sustained within me perpetually, because the thing about it is that I held it so tight due to the fact that if I lost it, then I would have lost my identity, and these memories were, I guess, integral to sort of finding my way home.
Did you ever try to put it out of your mind growing up that there was this sister, this brother, this mother that was probably looking for you?
No, never. I would have kept that till the day that I died.
This is where you live.
When Saroo was first with us, though, and we'd go out to the supermarket or whatever, It was invariable that Saroo would find something on the floor, be it a coin, a hair clip. He'd always come home with a little thing, and the kindest little one that he ever gave to me was this beautiful little butterfly. But he said, no take. He was worried that I thought he might have.
So
I said, where'd that come from? And then he pointed to the ground and he picked up this little thing, and I never made him feel bad about it, because it surely helped him to survive in India.
You put up a map of India in your house. Why was that important?
We had no idea where the boys really came from, but we wanted to show respect to the country. So the map, of course, was an integral part of his bedroom that he came home to. You know, sometimes I think of it, we tried to make it look like a Maharaja's palace.
You know, did you really?
Yes, it had, you know, Indian decor, bright colours. You know, for us as a family, we ate Indian food. It really was an ode to his first life.
23 years later, after growing up with my adoptive family in Tasmania, I discovered Google Earth.
It is probably one of the most improbable things that there was, in fact, one night where you did, through what I understand to be almost random clicking through Google Earth, actually found your house. Can you take us back to that night?
It was late, like I finished work, and then around 2 o'clock in the morning.
And you're just clicking.
And all of a sudden came to a railway line, zoomed down, followed it, and bang, there it was. The first thing I saw as I zoomed in was the water tower, and then went to the right a bit and saw the sort of a horseshoe driveway. And these landmarks were perfectly placed as well as being there too.
And how are you feeling at this point, as these clues are starting to fall into place?
Not convinced.
Really? Yeah. Skeptical?
Cause it's, skeptical, yeah.
Is it dangerous just, to have too much hope?
Yeah, it is. Like, there's been many times where I've just walked away in dismay and thought, you know, what am I doing? Each time I get my hopes up, I just get excited and then, you know, they get shattered. And I thought to myself, well, let's play a game. Can you convince yourself that you know the way from the dam to the centre of the city? And so I just scrolled and took a little bit of a left and a right and through some nooks and crannies. And I thought, to the left, there's a cinema, zoom down, yep. And then on my right-hand side is the three-platform train station that I used to hang out all the time, and there I was.
And when was the moment he revealed to you that he had found it?
Saroo was at work and he went into John's office and said, you know, just really straight out, I think I found my home. We hadn't known that Saroo was searching, so it was pretty incredible. We were, you know, quite worried, I guess, and certainly the departure at the airport was pretty tough. But I did give him a photo of him when he was little. That was how people would have remembered him, including his mother. He just virtually tossed his bag in the hotel and walked into the slums and was led around the corner to where his mother was. He found his family really within hours of arriving in his town.
I'm wondering if you could talk to that kid and tell him about what would happen. What would you have told him?
Whilst he's holding that chocolate bar.
Yeah, eat it now.
I'd say, you know, I think you're going to have from what you went through, you're going to have a very colourful life ahead of you. Who would have ever have thought, you know, from that kid sort of walking through the VIP and meeting his, you know, future family, that, you know, something like this would ever come about. You could have been out of this earth and at a very young age, but the heavens, you know, pushed and pulled and this is my destiny.
Guys, thank you so much for talking to us. Really appreciate it.
Thanks very much.